Today I'm talking about train accidents, specifically the ones I've covered here on my channel. I want to discuss how I report on them, why, and if it's the right thing to do. I've actually made videos about 3 separate train derailments. 2 of those I just happened to be in the right place at the right time, or the wrong place, depending on how you look at it. Fortunately, all 3 of these accidents I've told you about were relatively minor and no one got hurt. But derailments are still fairly unusual events to the general public, and all of these videos have garnered a lot of interest on YouTube. So how and why do I make videos about these incidents? Well, in every video I do, I try to find a story. I want to know what's really going on, and the accidents I've seen have definitely run the gamut. Steam, electric, and diesel trains, both passenger and freight. The first derailment I covered was in Somerville, Georgia. The front wheels of a steam engine came off the tracks after running over packed gravel at a crossing. A fairly minor incident, but the way the engine's crew dealt with it was impressive. With no heavy equipment, these men used only the tools they had on their engine to get the train back on track. It was definitely a showing of strength, skill, and ingenuity. Contrasting this accident was another derailment, this time involving 3 Norfolk Southern diesel locomotives that likely snagged a switch outside a busy Atlanta rail yard. We're talking about a Class 1 railroad here, so for them, time is money. They rushed in heavy equipment to get the job done. But even with these modern tools, this was still an engineering challenge, and one that required multiple companies to work together to safely and efficiently make things happen. These guys were extremely skilled, and it took them only 1.5 hours to get these locomotives re-railed. The last accident I want to talk about involved these rapid transit cars, which belonged to Atlanta's transit agency, MARTA. Like the freight locomotives, these cars snagged a switch and were grounded. But the heart of the story here wasn't the aftermath or the cleanup. It was the fact that the derailment happened at Atlanta's Hartsfield-Jackson, the world's busiest airport. Countless passengers and workers depend on these trains, and MARTA had to figure out how to keep operating despite what had happened. They ultimately were able to get one track clear so other trains could pass, and they eventually brought in a crane to help re-rail the affected cars. Luckily, that story, like the rest, had a happy ending, but is there a bigger philosophical question here? Are these videos just sensationalized clickbait? Well, in my case, I would say no. Of course, these certainly aren't my favorite types of videos to produce. I would rather my heavily researched historical content get more of the attention, but I am glad these pieces drive traffic to my channel, and hopefully they expose people to some of the other topics I cover. In the end, I hope that all the documentary-style videos I make are informative, interesting, and help to document history. That's the kind of content I like to watch, and those are the types of stories that I want to tell.